Think prevention, live long.
I'm Dr. AJ Shah. I'm going to explain you the results of echocardiogram, which is the ultrasound of the heart. You already had the test, so you're familiar with the machine and the way the test was done. The reason ultrasound of the heart or echocardiogram is typically done is to look at how the heart muscle is contracting. And as you can see it here, the heart muscle contracting right here. And we also look at the size of the heart, different chambers of the heart. We look at the valves. Heart has four valves, and we look at each valve in very detail. We look at see if the valve is leaking or if the valve is narrow. We look at the covering of the heart also. So again, it's a very detailed ultrasound of the heart. We look at the aorta, which is the main artery which comes out of the heart. When I sit down with you, I'll explain you all the details of the results. Most of the time when we do the ultrasound, if there is a serious finding, like a serious narrowing of the heart valve or serious leak of the heart valve, or if the heart muscle is very weak, or if there is any major concern, the person, the ultrasound person who did the test on you, will make sure that I see your patient right there. You will not even leave the office that day. So if you're back here for the results, it's a good chance that your ultrasound of the heart showed moderate concern or no major concern. When the leak, or when the valve is leaking moderate level or less, we typically will be able to watch it probably on a yearly basis or sometimes every 3 to 5 years. If the heart muscle is contracting properly, most of the time we just watch it on every few days. If you have a high blood pressure, many times we see that your heart muscle is getting thick. We call LVH. So if I explain you that your heart muscle is getting thick, it's nothing but a reflection of having high blood pressure for some time. So if you have a high blood pressure, it's very common to see the heart muscle is getting thick. If blood pressure is very well controlled over many years, many times we see that heart muscle actually is getting less thicker or almost it's regressing the thickness of the heart muscle. That's what I like to see in everybody, in all our patients. Most of the time when I sit down with you and give you the results of ultrasound, good chance that we will not find anything serious requiring any major procedure. Few times we will find a seriously leaky valve or a narrow valve or heart muscle being so weak that we will need to schedule you for further testing, typically in the form of either cardiac catheterization, and as you know, where we go through the groin, go up to the heart, inject the dye, and take the pictures of the heart. And if the valve, the heart valve is concerned, or sometimes we see a concern for the clot in the heart, then we will do a different type of ultrasound where a tiny probe, a tiny tube is put through the mouth in the esophagus, and ultrasound is done right there because we can get to the heart, very close to the heart, by putting a tube through the mouth and taking pictures from there. So again, at times after the ultrasound, if you find more complex, more concerning issues, then you will require either cardiac catheterization or TEE, which is nothing but a simple ultrasound done through the mouth, putting a tube in the esophagus while you are at light sleep and finding out whether the valves are leaking more seriously or not, or whether you have a clot in the heart or not. And obviously I'm going to sit down and explain you all this thing, but this video just makes life a little easier for you to understand what I'm talking about. So I'll see you in a few minutes. Thank you.
When we think prevention, live long, the heart of Mid-Michigan strong.